Greetings. So, remember we discussed about acute monoarticular arthritis. So we've talked about trauma. Next thing to talk about is infection. So again, it's acute monoarticular inflammatory, it's asymmetric arthritis. This is the big reason when somebody comes in to the emergency department with acute monoarticular asymmetric arthritis that the physician or the provider does a joint tap, extracts the fluid in the joint, and if it is opaque or pussy, along with fluid that has greater than 50,000 counts of WBC, it's septic. Essentially, what that means is there's infection in the joint. There is infection in the joint. Okay. Now, there's two kinds. So you can have gonorrhea in the joint, or you can have no gonorrhea in the joint. If it's gonorrhea in the joint, generally, you'll not see gram-positive cocci in clusters. So you do a nucleic amplification test, okay, which will then give you a diagnosis of, yes, you are indeed having gonorrhea, Neisseria gonorrhea in the joint, and you'll have gonococcal septic arthritis. If you don't see gonorrhea, it's non-gonococcal septic arthritis, and the biggest culprit is Staphylococcus aureus, where you're going to see gram-positive cocci in a cluster. So essentially, you have a patient comes in with acute monoarticular inflammatory asymmetric arthritis. Arthrocentesis is pus and greater than 550,000 WBCs. It's septic. You look under the microscope with a stain, and you get to see no gram-positive cocci in cluster. The next step is nucleic amplification test, and if it's positive, you got gonorrhea. If not, you got non-gonorrhea. Most common cause is Staph aureus, and generally, what you're going to see is either gram-positive cocci in cluster or no gram-positive cocci in cluster. Okay, so if it's no gram-positive cocci in cluster, and you do a nucleic amplification test where it's positive for gonorrhea, then you got Neisseria gonorrhea. If you see gram-positive cocci in cluster, it's Staph aureus. Okay, and again, it's going to grow in a few days. The problem is you don't wait for a few days. Okay. So what do? How do you treat gonococcal septic arthritis? How do you get it? The pathology is this is seeding through the blood. So in other words, the person engages in sexual activity, which is high-risk sexual behavior, acquires the sexually transmitted disease, which now disseminates through blood into other areas such as joint. Okay? So the patient is going to have a history of high-risk sexual behavior, along with the question. How do you treat it? You treat gonorrhea with ceftriaxone at this time. Again, check the infectious disease lecture, but again, you treat the gonorrhea. So at the time of creating this lecture, ceftriaxone is the drug of choice in the guidelines. But again, check out the infectious disease section. Because again, the resistance patterns and whether the gonorrhea is sensitive or not to ceftriaxone will determine whether they're going to be responsive to the treatment. And again, if you check the STD section in infectious disease, whenever you have gonorrhea, you treat for chlamydia. Whenever you have chlamydia, you treat for gonorrhea. So now that you found gonorrhea, you got to treat for chlamydia. Okay? And again, check the infectious disease section. So it's just generally for the medication that we give for chlamydia. Again, screen for other STDs. So remember, they go in clusters. So is there herpes? Is there HIV? And again, I think the STD section in infectious disease is a good place to start. Okay. That's gonorrhea, gonococcal septic arthritis. Okay. Now, what if it's non-gonococcal? Chances are it's Staph aureus. Okay. How does Staph aureus infect the joint? One, there's penetrating trauma. In other words, you have a foreign body, boom, goes through the joint, or is in the joint. Now you have environmental pathogen that has seeded the joint. What do you do about it? Well, penetrating trauma usually gets taken to surgery where there's washout and then it's cleaned up, repaired, antibiotics are given. Okay. Or the other one is it's done through blood. So in other words, if somebody is using IV drugs, or endocarditis, or they have IV lines that are infected and now are seeding the blood with Staph aureus. And the list can go on and on. But essentially, your blood has Staph aureus. And now that blood supply is going to take that Staph aureus to the joints like it will take glucose and oxygen. Here, the goal is to manage the underlying cause. So if they're doing IV drug abuse, stop it. If they have endocarditis, manage it. If the IV lines are an issue, take it out. So the first step, the important thing in this is to manage what's seeding the blood and take care of it, because if you don't, even as you're treating it, it's continually going to seed the joint and other areas. And then once we do that for both direct seeding and seeding through the blood, the goal is to treat Staph aureus based on sensitivity. And again, this is infectious disease, but general principles, methicillin sensitive Staph aureus is treated with navicillin. Methicillin resistant Staph aureus is treated with vancomycin. PO therapy or bi-mouth therapy, one can consider some other drugs like Bactrim or doxycycline, but again, that depends on antibiotic resistance in your area. The future of this is going to be determined by antibiotic resistance. But there was a time when penicillin was given initially to treat Staph aureus, and then it became resistant to penicillin, and then methicillin was given to kill Staph aureus, and then it became resistant to methicillin. And now we're looking at VRSA, which is vancomycin-resistant Staph aureus, for which we use linezolid. But again, it's continuously evolving, as are going to be these guidelines. And again, infectious disease is a good area to review. For both gonococcal and non-gonococcal, when you start to treat, what's going to happen? So there's two things to assess for: the patient and the disease. Okay. So if my antibiotic is working, patient's going to say, "Ah, feeling better." Okay. What about the swelling? It's going to go down. CRP, remember that marker? It's going to go down. Right? Fever? No fever. Excellent. Excellent. What about redness and heat? Gonna go down. Okay. If it's antibiotic failure, patient's gonna feel worse or not better. And when they have infection, they start to go into SIRS and sepsis. So if they start to get closer to that, and again, you'll study that in the infectious disease lecture, that means this patient's not getting better. They're getting into trouble. The antibiotics is not working. Time to call the physician or the provider. Okay? If it's getting worse, CRP is going to go up. Swelling's not going to go down. Okay? Your fever is going to come and probably going to rage, and redness and heat is going to be worse. Okay? So when you see that in your patient, that's the time to act, recognize, and rescue. That's what's going to be on the test. That's what's going to be in real life. So again, infectious or septic arthritis is acute monoarticular inflammatory asymmetric arthritis. Okay, confirmation arthrocentesis. Why do we do this? The joint's going to die and that infection's going to spread, cause sepsis, kill, after causing the patient to go into septic shock and multiple organ dysfunction syndrome. Okay, again, pus in greater than 50,000 WBCs. You may have gonorrhea in the joint, which is gonococcal septic arthritis, where you don't see positive coccine cluster, and when you do a nucleic amplification test, it gives you gonorrhea. If there's no gonorrhea, okay, chances are it's Staph aureus in the most cases. So you're going to see gram-positive coccine clusters. So if it's non-gonococcal and it's Staph aureus where you see gram-positive coccine cluster, usually you'd have a history of penetrating trauma, in which case they need surgery and a washout with antibiotics, or they're seeding through the blood. And if that's the case, we got to manage the underlying cause as we are treating the Staph aureus in the joint with Nafcillin for MSSA and vancomycin for MRSA. Okay, and then for gonococcal septic arthritis, the seeding is STD, which is now disseminated through the blood. Okay, so you'll have a history of high-risk sexual behavior. Again, you treat gonorrhea and chlamydia, check the infectious disease section, and screen for other STDs because they love to go together. Assessment, patient feels better, swelling goes down, CRP goes down, no fever, redness and swelling and heat goes down. If that means patient's getting better, antibiotic working. If it gets worse, patient says, I'm not getting better, CRP goes high, swelling doesn't come down, there's fever, redness, and heat is worse. That could indicate antibiotic failure, and it's time to get the provider involved to manage the situation. And that's septic arthritis, an infection.